Hi everyone, back again making another video. Actually this is probably the third time I've made this video. I just wanted to correct some things before I, you know, put all this information out or whatever. Well, first of all, we'll just start off with the really interesting thing that happened to me a couple days ago. Well, a couple days ago, my sister called me and she said she received a text from my mother. And my mom is like close to her set, almost 70. She really doesn't text. And apparently, Jehovah's Witnesses are becoming much more high tech now. They're sending out text messages to do their field service. My mom also said that she needed to get an iPad to do her field service now. So they're counting emailing as field service, text messaging as field service. You know, I really wish that was available when I was a kid, so I wouldn't have had to get up Saturday mornings and go knock on people's doors in the rain, sleet, snow, or whatever. But anyway, my sister also asked her a question. She was like, well, cool, I'm kind of glad to see that you're more so on the internet now. And maybe you can go to some websites and really investigate Jehovah's Witnesses. And she was like, oh, no, I can only go to the www.jw.org. You know, I'm not going to go to any other sites. They're just, everybody's lying on the organization, and everything they say about these lawsuits are not true and it's fake. And listen to this conversation with my mother. It made me so angry. I was like, oh my God. So I ended up calling her on the phone. And when I called her, she said she was in the car group at the time and it was her turn to wait in the car. But to be honest, people, I was a little heated and I went in on her. I really did. I just let her have it because, not really fuss at her, but I just wanted her to just hear some truth, or let's say hear reality. Okay. So I just told her, I just asked her a question. I said, is there anything that your governing body could do that would make you believe that they were false? Is it anything? Murder? You know, attempted murder, rape, child molestation, I don't know. Just things like that, you know, not, is it anything? Well, she was like, well, anytime they mess up, they make corrections. Anytime they mess up, they make corrections. And I'm like, mother, you cannot correct death. Can't correct molestations either. Because once it's done, it's kind of done. You know, you can't undo it. So they can't correct that. And so she was like, well, you know, she just got really upset with me or whatever about it. And I was like, this is just ridiculous. Like, you're thinking everyone in the world is lying. Everyone is lying? No, everyone isn't lying. That just doesn't even make sense. So after that, I just more or less hung the phone up and just kind of gave up on the whole conversation anyway. Because I rarely have conversations with my mother, but she wants some money from me. So that's the reason why she probably took my call. So anyway, so basically I thought about it, and on my channel I typically don't talk about scripture or get into doctrine very much, because I really don't feel like I need to preach at people about my beliefs, because if God wants them to believe the way that I do, or he'll make that happen, I don't necessarily have to beat people over the head with it, so I don't. But today I am going to say one scripture, and it's 1 Thessalonians 5:21, and it says, test all things and hold on to what is good. And I asked my mother in the conversation, I was like, well, you know, I told her that scripture, I said the Bible says test all things and hold on to what is good. Have you tested this? Have you tested this organization? Have you looked around and confirmed the data that what you're getting is true? And she was like, well, you know, the light gets brighter and brighter. You know, their Jehovah must be a piss poor ass God, because he can only let the light get brighter and brighter. Apparently, if the governing body is the direct, you know, source of information from God, they get a lot of things mixed up that they have to correct. So I don't quite understand that, because if you're talking directly to God, I would have to assume that his communication is perfect. So why do you keep getting it messed up? And if he has chosen you to communicate with, wouldn't he have a way of communicating with you that you wouldn't get it messed up, so you would be able to have, you know, correct information coming? And it's funny because Jehovah's Witnesses always talk about, you know, the Catholics, their arch nemesis, them having the Pope. But you have a middleman too. You have the governing body. You have the faithful and discreet slave. That's your middleman. It's your middle person, you know. So, I mean, I don't know. Jehovah just, apparently, he can't get it right, because every time he communicate, it's some type of weird, you know, they can't get it. Blood, scream, no scream, you know, all this type of stuff. It's just, they can't get it right. You know, they cannot get it right. I just think that you know, they might need to reexamine that. Like, really. Because if he can't really do it, then, you know, I don't understand it. It shows that he definitely needs to change up how he's doing things, because apparently they're not communicating things to them correctly. And I've never really quite understood, you know, they say they're the only channel to God. They're the only channel. So it's like, if you pray to God, apparently he not listening to you, period, unless you're dealing with, you know, Jehovah's Witnesses. And it's just crazy to me. And it's even crazier that they're trying to do, you know, field service by text and email. I know I have received like some letters in the mail before, like someone written me like a form letter from some witnesses before, that my mom encouraged to send me letters, which I had to definitely stamp that out real fast. But this whole emailing stuff, I mean, yeah, they're high tech now and they're sending out emails, but it's just as effective as what they're already doing, which is going out in the daytime, knocking on doors when people aren't home, making return visits to people that are still not home. And they're not converting anybody. It's a rarity that they're converting. Most of these people are converting friends and people that are closer to them. They are not making converts just by like, hey, can I come in and talk to you? It's not really happening like that. It's really not happening like that. And they don't have as many members as they say they do. They just don't take people off the books. I mean, if you died, you're still on the books. They're not wiping your name off. You're still there. They're still counting you. So it's far less of them than what they say is there. It's just, I don't know, it's crazy to me how they're doing that. You know, it's so ineffective to send old women out in the daytime to knock on doors, you know, pioneering, and no one is there. What's the purpose? That's because the governing body knows this is their scam. This is their scam. It will always be just around the corner. Always. I remember in the 90s. I remember when I was a child, I was told I would never grow up, and that, you know, never finish high school, any of that. I finished high school and college and then some, you know. And basically, this is a scam where they're always going to have that sense of urgency. They're doing ineffective things to spread the word, because they needed to be ineffective, because it makes the actual members feel like they're actually doing something when they're really not. They're not doing anything. They're just spinning their wheels. Knocking on doors, ain't nobody home. Knocking on doors, nobody home. And it's crazy. But I mean, I just really encourage any Jehovah's Witnesses that watch this to really test all things and make a decision. Is it the truth or is it reality? Which one is it? Because the truth get stuff wrong all the time and has to make corrections. Reality is what life actually is. It's what's actually going on. It's what's actually happening right now. And I think that's something you need to think about. Blue pill, red pill. Do you want to open your eyes and see things differently? Because when you sit back and you say that the governing body can do no wrong, it's nothing they can do to make you not question something that they did, that's a scary place to be. I'm pretty sure the people at Jonestown didn't question Jim Jones either. And look what he did. I mean, that's crazy. That is crazy. So anyway, like I said, you know, you need to make a decision. The truth or reality. Okay, everybody. See you in the next video.